Welcome to another edition of Biloxi A to Z, the insider's guide to what's happening in Biloxi. This is being recorded for Friday, October the 7th, 2022, and it's the Cruising the Coast edition. Thousands of cruisers and car buffs are in Biloxi and all along the Gulf Coast to partake in the 26th annual Cruising the Coast event. Hundreds were in Biloxi on Wednesday for the annual Downtown Block Party. Here's a little recap of the festivities.
Hello and welcome. We've got Chief Miller of the Biloxi Police Department here to talk to us a little bit about Cruising the Coast, the big event that's going on this week. And it's coast-wide, but we've got a lot happening today in Biloxi. Chief, tell us a little bit about what's going on and how things are progressing with traffic and what we can expect in the evening, that kind of thing.
Sure. We started attempting to park cars this morning about 5 o'clock, maybe a little after 5, trying to get everybody in place and everybody parked. There's always some confusion there because it's just a mass of people that are waiting in line to try to get parked.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of them have places where they would like to be. Unfortunately, parking that many cars, we just can't do that. It's the next slot, you take the next slot. So we had a little confusion there this morning, nothing that we haven't experienced before. But overall, all that went very well. And I think most of the participants are pleased and happy. Most of them just want to come, get parked, and start having a good time. So we've parked some areas this year that we haven't previously parked, mainly because there are some areas that we have used in the past that are now occupied.
And so right.
we're unable to use those. So we ended up parking cars in some other areas a little further away than we'd like. But unfortunately, we have so many this year. I think this is going to be a record year. Just going out, going through the crowd, it's very difficult to tell because they're expanding out so far. But it appears to me we have certainly have more spectators, and I believe we have more cars.
Well, we've got plenty of room to at least expand out, which helps with the overflow and the congestion, but obviously there's still going to be congestion, and people already that come to this and live here know that. So you're going to avoid certain areas at certain times. Can you tell us anything on that?
Sure, absolutely. If you're coming to cruising, come on down. If you're going to come out, come down, hang out, spectate, come on. If you're trying to go to the grocery store, go the other direction because you're not going to be pleased because of the amount of vehicles. I expect by this afternoon, once the block party's over at 2, most of this will clear out in here and we'll have a good bit of traffic on 90, but nothing that the traffic lights won't be able to handle. It will be a slower go than normal, but you just have to be patient and bear with it. Now going on further into the week, like by Friday, and this year we saw people early, so I think it may be by tomorrow instead of Friday.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to see traffic really back up. It's going to continue to move. We're going to see to it that it does, but you're going to see a lot of traffic and major delays if you're trying to get somewhere quick. Again, if you're out here just spectating, it's going to be fine for you. But if you're trying to get to work or something like that, please leave early. Give yourself plenty of time because I'm here to tell you traffic is going to be thick.
So it's business as usual as far as cruising the coast in the past. Similar, but we might be a little bit more congested. But it's beautiful weather, so we've got safe travels on the road. No wet roads or anything like that. So
that's right. That adds to the number of people
absolutely.
That want to come out, even spectators. You know, if there's a little rain or cloudy, they may not come. But the weather is absolutely
right.
Perfect. And the prediction is it's going to remain perfect through the weekend, and so I think we're going to see a record crowd.
Yep, and good news, no hurricane,
right.
So we got great weather and plenty of good food. I can smell it outside, so it's great. So,
yeah.
Well, we appreciate you being here with us today, sir.
Yes, sir.
And have a good
show.
Thank you very much.
And as the festivities continue throughout the weekend, expect the heavy, slow-moving traffic to continue along U.S. 90 and other thoroughfares throughout the city. Cruising organizers report over 9,000 registered vehicles for the event. And when driving along U.S. 90, hundreds of spectators can be seen lining the roadways to watch the cars cruise. As with any event in Biloxi that deals with U.S. 90, the Biloxi Police Department has a traffic plan in place, which includes the orange traffic cones along the roadway. The cones are in place in case police need to reserve the left lane for emergency traffic. To keep up with road closures and reopenings during the event, text Biloxi to 99411. Also this week, the Biloxi City Council had a regular scheduled first of the month night meeting at Biloxi City Hall. To see a recording of the meeting, visit the city's website at biloxi.ms.us. Click here, then click here. And work continues on park upgrades. Earlier this week, crews with Pelican Playground were installing the playground equipment at Businessman's Park on Forest Avenue. Also, at O'Reilly's Park off Division Street, New fitness equipment is being installed. And don't forget, it's flu season and COVID-19 is still around. So please follow safety protocols to lessen the spread of the viruses. Forecasters predict sunny and clear weather this weekend. Temperatures will range from the upper 50s to the mid 80s. The First Friday event takes place in downtown Biloxi on Friday night from 5 to 9 with live entertainment, food trucks, and vendors. Over at the casinos at the Beau Rivage, the Beach Boys will perform Friday night and Jay Leno will be there on Saturday. At the IP, Brandon Bennett will perform as Elvis on Saturday night. At the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, the Vicari Auction will take place as part of the Cruisin' the Coast festivities. Here is a look at the cruising happenings along the coast this weekend. We leave you today with what else but images from cruising the coast. Have a great weekend and we'll see you again next week.